One big plus of using Streamlit is how simple it is. Yet that simplicity often comes with a downside. There aren't many styling options available. All the UI elements like sliders, date pickers and select boxes, they all kind of look the same. So I was looking around and found a cool package that lets you use Shadcn components in Streamlit. What that is and how to use it is what I will show you in this video. But to give you an idea of how it looks, I have created this sample dashboard for you. So you will notice that the elements look different from the typical Streamlit style. In my opinion, it looks pretty clean and professional. So if you want to implement the same style in your Streamlit app, then stick around. First off, let me quickly explain what Shadcn is. In a nutshell, Shadcn is a collection of beautiful, designed, accessible and customizable React components that you can use to build modern web applications with Next.js. So it is mainly used by front-end developers. And on the official Shadcn page, you can see some examples. You will notice that this dashboard looks pretty similar to the one I created. That is because there's actually a package that lets you use those components in your Streamlit app. I will, of course, link the GitHub repo of the package in the description below. To get started, you just need to copy this command and run it in your command prompt or terminal. Once installed, let me grab this sample code. On my desktop, I have already prepared an empty Python file. So let me open it up and paste the code in here. With that in place, we can now spin up our app. Alright, so now we have a button, and when I click on it, we get this cool alert dialog. Of course, there are many other elements available. Here, on the following page, you can see all the examples and how to implement them. Once again, you can find the link in the description below. I will not go through all the examples here, but let me scroll through the page so that you can get an idea of what the different elements look like. Here on top, you can see the tabs elements, which I also used in my dashboard. Below that, we have a beautiful date picker, a nice data table, a button, a slider, text input boxes, and a couple of more elements. On the left, you will find the documentation on how to implement those elements. Let's say you're interested in the metric card. To get started, just copy the sample and paste it into your text editor. You will notice the syntax is pretty straightforward. You just need to import the Streamlit Shadcn UI package, and then you can use the different elements within your app. So when I go back to my page and refresh it, we can see our metric cards. Now to give you a more real-life example, I have put together the following dashboard for you, which I also showed you in the intro. It is actually fully functional. On top, you can see the total sales by city and also a comparison to the previous year. Below that, we have the tab element to group the sales either by month or product category. Then you can also select the city and decide if you want to switch to the previous year sales view. Now I might actually make a separate video to give you a full walkthrough of the code and explain everything in more detail. However, in this video, I will keep my explanation brief. After the imports, I have created a small section for some configurations and also the URL to the dataset. By the way, feel free to use this dataset to play around with it. It is just some dummy sales data ChatGPT and I put together. It's hosted on GitHub. And you guessed it already, but you can find the link to it in the description box as well. So after the configurations, I wrote a function to read in that data and add a month and a year column to it. Also, I'm using here a caching decorator so that my app is more responsive when filtering the data later on. Then I'm calculating the total yearly revenue for each city and year. And like we have seen earlier, I'm using the metric card here. Below the metrics, I'm using the tab element to switch between the monthly view and sales by product category. Afterwards, I use the select components to choose a city. And after that, I also included a toggle switch to switch to the previous year's view. Alright, and then in the last part, I'm just filtering my data based on the selection I have made above. As a result, I will now have my filtered data, which I now need to plot. You can use a standard Streamlit bar chart for that, however, I wanted to have rounded corners for the bars, so that is why I'm using a 𝗌𝗎 light chart here. This block of code just defines how the chart should look. To actually plot it, I am embedding the chart in a card container. And that's basically it. As I said, I might actually make a separate video to go into more details of the actual code. Okay, and before you go, let me also point out some current limitations of the package. My initial idea was actually to create a dashboard in dark mode. However, I noticed that the dark theme is not yet fully supported. For example, the toggle switch here is pretty hard to see. And if you open the select box, you will notice a white space around the selection items. So for now, it seems to me that it only works with the light theme of Streamlit. So keep that in mind when you are using that package. Okay, and with that said, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.